Good morning again. So we had a longer break now between the last and the presentation now. So you're all curious what comes. And Peter Martin is joining us from the Netherlands. It's not so far away, but he's still, you're in your office or where are you? Or at home?
I'm currently in my office because it's much more quiet.
Oh, much more quiet. Oh, that's good. So because nobody else is working there.
Exactly.
They all have weekend and only you are there. Okay, so great. 24 hours online, Jane Beyond, not in Lissabon. Bad, bad, bad. We're so happy when we can meet in person, but there is something happening in the world that we cannot do this year. But we're still alive and and now you will learn a little bit about Joomla, and especially Joomla under the hood. So some insights from Peter. Peter, it's your
Okay,
turn.
thank you. Welcome to this presentation, Joomla Under the Hood. The name is American English. Joomla itself is British English. I mean the language file, so it should have been Joomla Under the Bonnet or Bonnet, but I thought Joomla Under the Hood sound better, so therefore Joomla Under the Hood. In this presentation, all the blue links are links, hyperlinks to external sources. So yeah, you can visit it later. My name is Peter Martin. I'm a Joomla volunteer. And besides volunteering in the Joomla community since 2005, I organize a monthly Linux user group here in my hometown, Nijmegen, the Netherlands. And I organize monthly business meetups for entrepreneurs in the morning with coffee once a month. I have my own company. That's where I am now. In the middle of Nijmegen. My company is called DB8, and I do Joomla support and custom development for websites. Besides that, I'm co-founder of Data2EU, and we have an online processing index tool. So it's software as a service, and every company needs to have documentation about which information they process about persons. And with our tool, it's easy to create such an index. And besides that, I'm also a co-founder of Data2Site, and we have a component in the making. It's called D2 Content. Hopefully next week I have more news about that. So in this presentation, I will tell you something about how Joomla works. And for people who are already developing and programming, a lot of this could be already known knowledge. However, I hope to give you a couple of new insights in some of the features of Joomla and also in how to explain stuff to normal people. I mean, people who are no programmers. So let's start with object-oriented programming, which means you have a class. That's the sort of blueprint what an object can do. The object itself is an instance of that class, and it has methods, and that are actions that can be done by an object. And I think that this could be very, this is a bit of abstract. So let's do it in a more practical approach, and let's compare it with a cake recipe. So if you look at how a cake recipe looks like, it's something like this. First, you have to heat the oven, and then you have to mix something. And further on, it also says mix. The recipe doesn't tell you anything about which mixer you have to use or how to do the mixing. It just says you have to mix certain things. The mixer in this case is an object. So you can use a hand mixer. You can use another object that's also a mixer, like an electric one or even a fancy one. It doesn't really matter which mixer you use. You just put something in and you get a result out of it. That's the first thing. The second thing is, you don't have to know the inner working of the object. I mean, you can open it, but you can look at it, but to use it, you don't really know the inner workings. And finally, the object can be reused for other things. I mean, you can make cake dough of it, but you can also use it for other stuff. So another thing with objects is that you can extend objects. So what you can see here is a Hans and Gretel house. It's made by my daughter a couple of years ago. My daughter wanted to make this for her birthday. She didn't know how to make cake, and she needed this, a cake. What she knew was she could use me. She could ask me, "Daddy, can you bake me a cake?" So I became an object. I was using a recipe, which was for me an object, and the recipe had a mixer inside it because it said mix stuff. So I was using the mixer. So that's how you can extend objects in real life. And you also do this with Joomla, I mean with code. Another concept in Joomla is MVC, Model View Controller. And this means you have to separate logic stuff. For instance, the data will be in a model, like maybe you have a video VCR player or something. That's the data. Then you have the view, which presents the data to the visitor. In this case, a television, it's the view. And then you have a controller. With the controller, you can determine what you want to push to the view. Of course, in this case, these things here don't mix together because the television is really old vintage and the remote control is from some other device. But anyway, it's just how it works. So if you look in a schematic, you start with the address of the page. The address of the page determines the route, and that will trigger the controller on the website. The controller might want information. It asks to the model, and the model will get it from the database, pass it back to the controller. Then the controller will pass it to the view, and the view will display it to the visitor. This is the model view controller in a nutshell. So getting back to Joomla, Joomla has extensions. And if you look at the extension types that Joomla has, it has component plugins, modules, templates, and languages, but also libraries and packages. And each of those extensions have their own details that I want to tell you something about. So components are the most important thing in Joomla. A component determines what happens in Joomla. You can have only one on a page, but a component can have multiple views or actions. So a component can maybe have something like a create, read, update, or delete. A component is activated by Joomla via the URL. The URL have something like option.com_component, like option.com_content, and then the com_content will be run, and com_content will look at what view and also what actions the visitor wants on that page. The template has a part, just one line of code, which says JDoc include type is component. And the template knows that there should be the component output. It's also possible to override the output of your components, and I come to that later. So components have also this model view controller. So the model is the interface to the data in the database. The view does the HTML output, and you can override it. And the controller defines the create, read, update, and delete actions. And maybe you also have other actions. Display is the default controller. Then the next one is plugins. Plugins are running in the background of your website, and they mostly do just one thing. You can have multiple plugins active at the same time, and they are activated because they listen to certain hooks that are in the code. They are triggered. So a plugin will be triggered by, first you have to say something like import plugin, and then the name of the group, like maybe you do something in the com_content. The Com Content has its own group, and it's called Content. So you will do import plugin content, and it will load all the published plugins that are assigned to Content. And it will run it in order. So you have to look at the ordering in the backend of Joomla, of the plugins, and the first one will be run first. In the code itself, it will trigger a method, an event. And a method is a function that is in the plugin. I will show you more about that later. So there are different plugin groups. The system plugins are the most important ones because they run all the time. Every time you visit the page, the system plugins are loaded. The content plugins are only loaded when the content plugins are triggered, and it's mostly done in com content. But if you have your own component, you also can just run content plugins if you like, or you can create your own plugin group if you want to. It's really flexible. So the third extension type is called modules, and modules are just a plain view of something. You can have multiple modules on a page, but they have only one action. They display something. They are activated by menu items, and it's because the URL says something like end item ID equals a number, and then all the modules that are assigned to that menu item will be loaded. And when I say item is equals one, equals X, you don't see it in the URL if you have the search engine friendly URL on, but Joomla will convert it back so it knows exactly what to trigger. So the modules are displayed in the template because you can put something like JDoc include type is modules, and then the name of the module group that you want to publish there. You can also load modules in your articles, but then you have to enable a plugin that will trigger to load the modules in an article when they are called for. It's also possible to override the modules. The structure is really simple for modules. You always have an entry point, like mod_breadcrumbs.php. And you always have an XML manifest file. And the manifest file is used for the installation, for third-party extensions, that is, and for its parameters. With these files, you can already have a module. If you want to do some more fancy stuff, like getting data from a database, you probably need a helper, and the helper will act as a model. And finally, you might want to use the TMPL, because if you put your view stuff, the HTML stuff, including some PHP in TMPL default, then you can override it in the template override. About templates. Templates are the layout of the website. They consist of some HTML and CSS and certain elements. And with elements, I mean the modules and the component position that are defined on the page. You can have one template per page. A template is activated because it's assigned as the default template for the whole site. But you can also assign other templates to certain menu items, so you can change your view in the website. There is one thing. It will only always display, except when you put *TMPL equals component. If you put that in the URL, then the template will not be loaded. So you don't have all the modules, etc., only the template output. To change the output of components or of modules, you create a template override. And you do that by just copying the TMPL output of a component to a certain folder. In this instance, I use protostart as a template. I create an HTML website, HTML folder, and there com content is the component, and then the name of the view that I want to override. For instance, I can copy the blog.php and the blog.xml, and I put it in that folder. If I use other names, like maybe instead of blog, I copy it and call it portfolio, then I have an alternative template override. So meaning I can still use the default template output, but if I want to have on certain menu items a different layout, I can activate it by retrieving my portfolio.php override. Then we have languages. Languages are used to translate stuff. In Joomla, we use a lot of system labels. And also when you have multilingual websites, then you have different labels, different language files with different labels. You can have one language on a page, and it's activated by because of you you said that the default language would be something, and then the language will be loaded, and also the language overrides that will be loaded. To display a language string, you should do something like echo text or jtext language label, and in your language file you put something like language underscore label with uppercase letters, and then the label that should be displayed, you can override those, and that is really neat. So you can have core layout files, language files, like comcontent.ini or modbreadcrumbs.ini. They are both in language, engb, and then in that file. In the backend, you also have language files, and then it's administrator language, and for in this case, engb. So if you have a third-party component, I always put the languages in my own component, because if I install it, the language is already there. And for instance, if I have Dutch in it and people install a Dutch language file, then my component immediately works with the same, with my own file. Otherwise, you have to let them install them later on. And also with development, it's easier because you have everything in one folder. Overrides are easy. You can do it in the backend. And if you do it in the backend, so you go to extensions, languages, overrides, language overrides, then you can create language overrides. And you will notice that there will be a file created. In this case, language/overrides, engb. .override.ini, which contains all the overrides that I create for the English language. And it has all the language files, all the overrides just in one file. Now something about libraries. Normal, regular users won't really use these. It's more for developers. If you use code, or if you want to reuse code, then libraries can be a good method. So in your library file, you put all the classes and all the methods that you use in your components. A couple of developers do that. And Joomla itself also uses libraries a lot. So an example is, if you go to libraries, vendor, there is a vendor name called phpMailer, and it has a package called phpMailer. So this is how Joomla uses libraries. And Joomla uses Composer, which is a really nice tool to do dependency management. So it's easier to keep your libraries, your PHP libraries, up to date. It also has an auto-loader function, which is really nice. If I create components that have libraries and I use Composer, then I put the libraries in my own component folder. If you put your files with Composer in libraries vendor of Joomla, then you will also update all the Joomla packages. So if PHPMailer has a new version, it will automatically update. And you don't want to do that because then your Joomla website has different libraries than the default Joomla website. And if you run into problems, you don't know if it's because of a new package or because something else. So in Joomla 4, I hope this this will be corrected. That it's easier to put all the libraries just in one folder. But I don't know exactly if that's how it will be handled. Finally, we have packages. So if you have multiple extensions, like you have a component with a couple of modules, in the past, people had to install the component and then to install one module, two module, etc. You can package them in a package. So you just install the package. It will be easier to combine your extensions, which makes the installation easier. After it's installed, you can display a message. And yeah, this is a really nice system. Also, when you delete the package, all the components and modules and plugins that were in the package will also be deleted. So, how to get a website, a web page? When I started with Membo and Joomla, and I explained people how a content management system works, I always said something like, yeah, it's just a PHP file, a couple of PHP files that will connect to a database, get information from the database, and publish the information on the page. That is how a content management system works. And that is really a sort of easy, not complete version of how it really works, because the reality is much more complex, and I will give you an insight now about it. It's about the Joomla runtime. So I would like to explain to you what happens when you visit a Joomla website. And actually, you can visit a Joomla website on the front end or on the back end, like in the administrator folder. I will explain you the front end now. The back end is quite similar. So the first thing that happens, if someone visits your website, for example, it's example.com, the web server gets a request for a page. And if there is no page requested, I mean, then it will hand back the default page. So if you ask for example.com, the web server might give back index.php. Joomla's index.php starts with define yexec1, meaning it will create a constant called yexec, and it equals it to 1. All other files of Joomla are protected, and they are protected with browsing protection. That is, if a file says something like defined, yexec or die, then if someone tries to retrieve it directly, like you go to example.com/component/comcontent/controller.php, then it should not be visible, it should not run. So it will die. But if Joomla tries to open that file, it's okay because yexec is set. So because it's set, it doesn't die, and then you can continue with the process. So this is the first thing that happens when you open, when somebody visits your website, the yexec will be defined. The second thing is Joomla will load the locations of all the folders. So there's a file called includes/defines.php, and it specifies where the libraries are, where the plugin folder is, where the themes, the templates are. And after that, the index.php will then load a file called includes framework.php. And that file starts with yexec or die because it only should be loaded by Joomla itself. And then it will load from the JPOD libraries that's just defined, the cms.php. And after that, it will do something with error checking, and then it will check if the Joomla is installed correctly, because if there is still an installation directory, then you get a message like you have to remove the installation directory before to continue. Then the index.php will, the framework will load the configuration.php. It will set the system configuration, and it will then also set the error reporting level. After this framework has been loaded, the application will start. And that's the last part of index.php. It will instantiate the site application, and then it will execute it. So far, everything goes okay. And now we run all the applications that are just loaded, so all the classes. So we just loaded the CMS application. Because we are now on the front end of Joomla, we are also loading the site application and the factory application. Those are needed to run Joomla properly. Then the app will be initialized. That means, is there a user active, logged in? And also the session will be retrieved. Every page refresh or every page that you visit, this will be checked. And now this is very important. The first plugin event will be triggered. It says system on after initialize, meaning the system plugin will be triggered. And the system plugins that have a method called on after initialize will run their code. After that, we are going to the route method. So you have a URL, and the URL will have an option, a view, an ID, and an item ID. The option is used to determine which component should be loaded. And the view and the ID will be given to the component. The component will get that to determine what to do in the component itself. And after that, we will have another system plugin. And this system plugin is called on after route. So if you want to do something with your plugin just after getting the route, this is the place to trigger it. So now we have the component, and now the component will be dispatched, meaning all the control will go to the component, and the component will do the get document, the router, and the params. Then the render component will be done. And then we have another plugin event, also system, of course, and it's on after dispatch. Now we are going to the last bit, rendering the page. So now the template index.php will be executed. The template index.php has first a plugin event on before renderer, then the document will be rendered, like all the modules are rendered on the page. And then we have three plugin events, the on after render, on after compress, and on after respond. On after compress is after the gzip compression stuff has been done. So if it's a decompile stuff, yeah. And then finally, when nothing happens, the real last step is after respond. So these are the places where you can trigger system plugins. So summarize. First, you execute the index.php, and it starts the Joomla runtime. It will define the locations. It will load the framework. It will start the application. Then it will get the route URL. And because of the route URL, it knows which component to trigger. And after that, the page will be rendered. This is how Joomla works. And now I would like to tell you something about core functionality that you can use in your own components, and all components can use these functionality. So let's start with the core menu. Menus are used in Joomla for the navigation. They will trigger the component and also the view of the component, and they will load the assigned modules and templates for that page. You have, of course, front-end modules. It's since Joomla 1.0. But I think it was since Joomla 3.8 that we can make our own back-end menus, which is really a nice feature. So you have front-end and back-end modules, menus. And menus use two tables. There is a menu types, which defines the names of the types of the menus. and you have menu, which has all the items. Something with the menu table is that it uses nested sets. And with nested sets, I mean the following. If you look at the table structure, you can see the table structure of the menu table. You can see all kinds of fields. And a couple of fields are called LFT and RGT. And these two are left and right. And with these two, Joomla knows all the order of the menu items, but also if a menu item has children items. And this is a really nice structure made by Mike Hillier. And the URL at the bottom will show you a lot of these kind of schemes, but also SQL statements to retrieve information about the schemes. For instance, if you look at the left bottom, it says tube, and then you have left is 3, right is 4. So if you have this as a menu item, left LFT is 3 and RGT is 4. Between LFT and RGT, there is no other number, meaning it doesn't have any children. And because LFT 3 is before LFT 7, the tube will be displayed before the plasma. Joomla also has another field, and it's called path. And there also are the URL structure placed. So if you have been doing stuff in your menu and it looks a bit funky because of the dragging and dropping, you could do the rebuild. If you choose menu rebuild, then it will recalculate the LFT and RGT fields. So if you have, for instance, by accident, two of the same LFT fields, then it tries to change it a bit, that the structure will be okay again. And it will also rewrite the path field in the database table. Let's look at the categories, which is another powerful feature in Joomla. The categories in Joomla, they are for grouping data. If you think about the categories for articles, that's the most used, I think, then it's really nice that you have a lot of, if you have a lot of articles, like you have news articles, that you can put all the news articles in the category called news. Then in the backend, it's easier to filter. The fun part is the categories can be used in your own components as well. That is, you have to use com categories in a certain way. It also uses nested sets, just like the menus, what I just told you about. And there is a nice feature called item counter that you can use. The categories use only one table called categories. And if we look, for instance, at how articles work, if you go to content, articles, you will have an overview of all the articles. And with search tools, you can filter the articles on certain categories if you like to. The URL will show you administrator/index.php :option=com-content, meaning that com content should be active, which is it now. And view is article, so it will show a list of the articles. On the left, you have a menu which says articles, categories, featured articles, fields, and field groups. But if you click on the categories there, what happens? If you go to content categories, it will be active, it will be highlighted. And if you look at the URL structure, you will see something like administrator index.php, option is com categories, and extension is com content, meaning you are now in a different component. You are now using com categories. But with extension is com content, com category knows, okay, he or she wants to see the categories for the com content component. So the com categories knows which extension you are looking at, and it will load the helper file of that extension. So if you do com categories and extension is com content, the com categories component will load from the com content component the helper file, which is called content.php. And that helper file has a method called add submenu, and with that add submenu, the left menu will be built. So therefore, you can have the same menu on the left, even if you are not in COM content anymore. And this feature you can also use for counting data. So Joomla, if you go to the categories, you can see a list. The balls on the right side with the circles with the 8111, meaning I have 8 published articles in the category Joomla. You can have this feature in your own component as well. So if you use COM categories and you have extension is and then your component name, then the helper file of your component will be triggered and it should have a count items method, and then you can count the items. And if you count items and display them, COM category will display it on the right side of the screen. So everybody knows that updating software is essential to be safe and also be effective. I mean, if you have software that's out of date, then maybe it's not running smoothly or so. So keep everything up to date. Joomla has a nice update feature, and it's available in the administrator if you go to extensions. And then it's in the COM installer extension. It has 2 views. One is called update and the other is update sites. And those views are necessary for the updating. So what the update extension of Joomla does, it will show update notifications if there are updates available for third-party extensions. And it makes it also possible to use the one-click update mechanism. Note that this is not the same as the Joomla CMS update, because that uses another component. It uses com_Joomla update. There are a couple of tables used for the update. The first table is extensions. The extensions table of Joomla holds all the information of the installed extensions. The update sites and the update sites extensions are used to keep track of the URLs that should be checked if there are any extension updates. And the updates will have a list of all the updates that should be done. So if you write your own component, you should have an XML manifest, because the XML manifest gives information about who's the author, what's the name of the component or a module of plugin. And also it will define the files and folders that should be installed. It might do something with the database, like creating data or data tables. It will maybe load language files, and you use it to set parameters in your extension. What you also can do, there's something called update servers. If you use update servers in your XML manifest, you can define which XML should be checked to see if there are updates for your component or plugin or module. So what happens is that on another website, on your own website where people can download it, you could make available a file. A file that should be checked, and the file should have something like updates, the name of the component, then the element. In this case, it's a package called D2 content, and there is a version 1.1.0. In case I have 1.0.0 installed on my website, the 1.1.0 here is more recent. So Joomla should give you an update notification that there is an update available. And then you should be able to install it. So the extensions table has the information about the extensions that are installed, and also if they're published, etc. The update underscore sites has information about the extension of the developer site. And the update site extensions will link those entries in the update underscore sites with the extensions that are in the extensions table. And finally, you have the updates table that has the available updates listed. So if you go in the backend to extensions, manage, update, you do clear cache and then do find updates, it should synchronize the updates table with the external things. If there are any external changes, then it should be put in the updates table that there is an extension update available. However, sometimes you run into problems. You don't see those. And what you can do is you can do manage extension manage update size and then rebuild. And if you rebuild it, then it will rebuild to update size table. One thing to note here, if you have unpublished some of the update site entries, they will be published again. So this should be done with care. There's another functionality called the versioning. And versioning is really nice. It keeps the track of the versions of items. So if you save an article and you are using this, the old article content is saved in the US UCM history table, and the new article is saved in the article in the content table. You can use this for your own extensions as well. To enable it, go to content articles options and say enable versions yes. Oh yeah, and the data is saved as JSON field, JSON data, and you can compare versions. Another nice feature is ACL. ACL means access control level. And with ACL, you can determine the authorization of the permitted actions. It uses the com config and then the component, a views component, and then the component is the component name. It also uses nested sets. It uses Joomla's user groups that's already used for the users. And it has an assets table where it will make connections with the user table and also what is permitted with a certain action. So if you look at the Joomla frontend, if a visitor is allowed to see something, then in the backend, you can use the access levels, like viewing access levels. Like maybe you want to make something registered. And if the front end, if the user is in registered and they are logged in, they will see it. This is not really what I was talking about now, because the ACL, what I'm talking about is the component permitted actions in the back end. So in order to use it in your own component, create a file called access.xml. In that file, you can define per section what should be used and also what actions should be done. And those are stored in the assets table. And in your own component, you should do stuff like checks. If com content article, then is this user that's now logged in, is it able to do core edit? And if they are able, then you can do it. The tags are a bit similar like categories, but different, because categories are just for a component and tags are over the components. So you can use one tag and use it in different components. There is one issue with it. There's no language association with tags. So if you use tags, there's just one. We have custom fields, almost finished. Custom fields are amazing because you can extend all your stuff with new fields. Like you can add new fields to your articles, but also to your own components. And to get all the information, all the fields, for example, for a com article, you do something like this, what you see here. And then you have all kinds the item objects for every field. Finally, the privacy. There's a component called comprivacy, and you can use it for giving registering permissions, but also register the request of people asking for the personal data or about removals. And it also has an API. So if you create a component that does something with processing information of users, then you can communicate what it does to the comprivacy. So that in the backend, the administrator can see what your component does with privacy things like personal data. So we are almost there. First, I told you, I've said something about core functionality that you can use in your own components, like menus, categories, update mechanism, how versioning works a bit, ACL tags, the custom fields that you can use, and also privacy. This is core functionality that you can use in your own component. I taught you something about the different extensions that Joomla has. And I also said something about how Joomla runtime work. First, you execute index.php, which will load the locations. And because of the locations, it knows where to get stuff. So it will load the framework of Joomla, and then it will start the application. The application will get a route from the URL in the address bar. And then it knows, because it says option is com, some component, which component to load and to execute. And finally, it will give it to the template that will render the page also with modules on it. That's how Joomla runs under the hood. I hope that everything is clear. Are there any questions?
Hi, yeah. So I think I'm the wrong person to have a question, but nobody else has a question. I'm sorry. So I think you made a brilliant presentation so that every question is answered. So what I'm saying is, was a great overview. Just happy visitors, happy viewers, visitors. Oh.
Great.
Yeah. So that's it's a long day. So Peter, if there are no questions, I would say we are done so far. I hope you enjoyed it to do this presentation. It's a little bit different with no audience. Yeah.
Yes. Yeah, I like to have audience. That's much better.
Yeah. Even if they throw tomatoes on you, so it's at least there's reaction.
Yeah.
Okay. Good. So thank you very much for joining us.
You're welcome.
And I wish you a good sunny day, and then I hope you find your bug you're looking for.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you for having me here, and have a pleasant day with all the other presentations.
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you very much. So we are now having a 10-minute break, something, and see you back in 10 minutes, roughly. That's it.